In this video, we're going to look at the four steps of problem solving applied to a word problem. The four steps are identify the problem, devise a plan, carry out the plan, and check your results. And we're going to try out these four steps on the following problem. What should the diameter of a swimming pool be if one wishes for the area to be 400 square feet? Round your answer to the nearest tenth of a foot. I've given this problem on a previous final and a lot of students could not do it. So let's see how this four-step method can help out here. Our first step is to identify the problem. Basically, we're finding the radius of a circle that has an area of 400 square feet. So I've drawn a sketch here of the circle, and a lot of times the sketch is very helpful. And I indicated R. The radius is half of the diameter, since diameter is all the way across. So once we find the radius, we then double it. So that means we have to have a formula that relates radius to area, and we have such a formula. In step two, we write down our formula, or gather all the formulas we need, and then devise a plan for finding the value we need. Well, we have a formula, a equals pi r squared. We have the value of A being 400. We use 3.14 as an approximation for pi, and then we have to solve for R. Once we solve for R, we just double it to get the diameter. So we carry out our plan. We let A equal 400. We let pi equal 3.14. We get the equation 400 equals 3.14 R squared. Now, to get r squared, we divide both sides by 3.14, and 400 divided by 3.14 is 127.389. So this gives us the equation 127.389 equals r squared. Now, to solve this algebraically, we extract square roots, or square root both sides, and we get the square root of 127.389 equals 11.3, and that's the value for R. And when we double that value of R, the radius, we get 2R equals 22.6 feet, which is our diameter. Now, there's an alternative to the algebraic method of extracting square roots. We could solve by trial and error to find that value of 11.3. If we take 11 and we square it, we get 121. And 12 squared is 144. That tells us that our answer is in between 11 and 12. 11.4 squared is 129.96, which is too much. But if we go down to 11.2 and square it, we get 125.44, which is not enough. That tells us that our answer to the nearest tenth is probably 11.3. So 11.3 squared gives us 127.7, which is very close to our 127.389. So by trial and error, we could get the answer of 11.3. Now it's time to move to step four, where we check our results. Does a radius of 11.3 give us an area of about 400 square feet? Well, we plug our answer into this area formula. A equals 3.14 times r squared. When we do that, we get 400.9 square feet. That's close enough. The answer's off a little because we rounded our answer. So we conclude that the radius rounded to the nearest tenth of a foot is 11.3 feet, and we have a diameter of twice that, which is 22.6 feet.